Yo, what's poppin'? It's Kendrick motherfucking Lamar.
Hey, what's happening, homie? This is T.I.P., man.
Yo, what's up? It's Big Boy. Y'all know what time it is. Live from the West Coast. You already know you checking out Hard Knock TV. You heard?
Yeah, what up, though? This is Common, and right now you checking out Hard Knock TV.
You watching Hard Knock TV, you understand?
Learn that, you yach.
What's up, man? It's Mac Miller right now. You're watching Hard Knock TV, and hopefully this video gets more views than the last one, because we getting views out here, baby. Millions and millions and millions. Yach! Blue Side Park, baby, coming soon.
Take over the world when I'm on my Donald Trump shit. Look at all this money, ain't that some shit?
We gon' take over the world while these haters getting mad. That's why all my bitches bad, they see this crazy life I have in A&R. We gon' win, you can take the loser draw. What I'm in, got these hoes who used to play me in they bras. We gon' take over the world while these haters getting mad.
This kid is the new Eminem. Everybody says he's fantastic, and let's see what it is, but the Donald Trump song just hit over 20 million. That's not so bad. I'm very proud of that.
Did he ever reach out to you? It was a YouTube video, though.
It was just a YouTube video. I thought that I actually wanted to speak on it. I thought that it was ridiculous how people got so worked up over him being like, "You're the new Eminem." Like, what do you want? What do you expect him to say? Right. Like, it's Donald Trump.
He's not. This is hip-hop.
Like, he's not gonna be like, "I was listening to this Mac Miller kid, and he seems influenced by a tribe called Quest. He seems like he listened to a lot of Big L growing up, and that he's really golden era hip hop." He's all he meant was like, "I'm a white rapper and I'm blowing up." Like, people were like, "All like, how could the Donald say that? Like, how could they say that Mac Miller is Eminem? They're different. Obviously, we're different, dude. Like, don't worry about what Donald Trump calls me. I was just excited that I've reached a level where someone like that, I'm on their radar."
Right.
About to hit him for just borrow the jet real quick. That man's got paper. Yeah, I'm gonna get there though.
20 million views will get anybody.
I know,
especially,
right?
When his name's on the title of your song.
He definitely thinks that he's like the coolest dude in hip hop right now. He's like, 20 million views, Donald Trump song. He was like, "I'm pretty proud of that."
Tell us about the new project. Is it a concept album?
I mean, the concept was basically like, after I got off tour, you know, shit was a lot crazier than before we left for tour. And it was kind of like, they were like, "Where do you want to work on your album? You know, do you want to go to LA and New York?" And I was like, "No, I want to stay home and work at home." And I had like trouble coming up with the title and the concept. And I kind of just decided like, man, it's all about just, I haven't even left where I came from, you know what I'm saying? Like, I live at my mom's crib right now, like, just cooling out, because I'm about to get a crib when I get back off tour, but I mean, it's just like, it's not like a huge thing for me. Like, I'm still the same kid when I go back home, you know, nothing changes, and so it's basically like, Blue Slide Park is like, kind of like, you know, life, you go crazy in life, you go out and become a big business mogul, you go out and do all the stuff in your life, and you come home and there's still the same park right there, and they could add jungle gyms, they could add whatever they add to the park to renovate and make it new, but like, the slide's still gonna be blue, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of just like an ode to, like, you know, really not only being truthful about where I came from and being honest about it, but loving it, you know what I'm saying? And loving the place I was raised in, you know what I'm saying? I live in Pittsburgh right now. You know how many people think I should be living in LA or New York or something? I live in the Berg, like, just chilling. When I get a crib, I'm gonna get a crib in the Berg, like, so.
You got some shit to say, I suggest you hold it in.
I'ma feed the world, you can put it on my tab. Run until my legs go numb, I don't plan on looking back. Anything you need, you can find it at the market. If you don't hold me down for all I care, you can starfish. I'ma feed the world, you can put it on my tab. Run until my legs go numb.
speak about the first video just dropped. That's the actual supermarket that you used to go to, or
yeah. I mean, I still get sandwiches. It's a deli. It's a deli, and what happened was in my neighborhood, Point Breeze, where I grew up, there's this place called Frick Park Market, and it's been around for ages. Like, I'm talking like, there's pictures of this building when it's like horse and carriages. Like, it wasn't called Frick Park Market then, but you know what I'm saying? It's been around for ages, and that's always been the spot. You know, when you were young and we used to like play football till 9 at night, we would go there and get slushies, and it's always just kind of been the spot we go to, and basically the spot we like, we get food, and it's just like my neighborhood spot.
Right.
And I was sitting there, and that's actually the last jam I recorded for the album, I believe, right? No, it's not. One of the last jams. And I was like, I really want a song called Frick Park Market, just kind of like about, you know, just everything you need right there
right.
at the market.
Now, when you go there, is there a special sandwich you order?
Or that's what I told them. I was like, yo, we're shooting this video. We need a Mac Miller sandwich. It's going to go nuts. And they might, I don't think they really know how big it is, you know what I'm saying? Like, to them, I'm like the neighborhood kid, and they're like, oh yeah, you can shoot your rap video here, like, you know, we'll be on it, and I'm like, it's gonna be on MTV. They're like, oh, what? Like, but, yeah, man, so I'm just kind of excited to put different places like that in my neighborhood on the map, and hopefully, you know, make them historic landmarks, if the album's big enough.
My name Mac Miller, who the fuck are you? Well, my crew too live, but I ain't Uncle Luke. And I ain't no hipster, girl, I can make your hipster from Pittsburgh, smoke papers over a Swisher. Welcome to the Cambrellum Chronicles, looking out my monocle. I'm dodging obstacles, I gamble like the Bellagio. You cockroach, I'm heroin, cause everything I dodge is dope. Type to leave it clean and fucking shiny, word of mop and glow.
Now, I heard that the album features no guest appearances.
Nobody.
And the production is pretty much your team from Pittsburgh.
I've wanted to do that for so long, you know. And it's kind of like, at the stage I'm at right now, I could go out and reach to get features and hit people up and really like work on that and have an album full of like dudes that I know personally that I could have on the album. And then production-wise too, like I could hit up dudes, I know people and people I've worked with them before previously. And everyone understood that it was like, man, I just want to do this with the people that really know me. Like. Cause when you get into album, you know, you're like, it's also like you're putting money in people's pockets, you know, like, so for me, I was like, I want to give like the people that have put in the hours, like Edan and Germ, like they've put in hours with me for nothing. You know, when I was 16, 17, putting together my mixtapes, they stayed up with me till Germ, E didn't come in till later. Germ stayed up with me for the jukebox, you know, when I was 17 years old, no one knew who I was. He stayed up with me till 7 in the morning, just putting it together, helped me put that together. Same with the High Life Germ, you know, did all that with me. And E came in, you know, and worked with me on Kids a lot and started working with me a lot after that. And it's just like the home place where like, I just kind of want to show that we can do it all, you know, and that they were really all I needed to go to. And it's no disrespect to anyone else. And I had talked with people about, you know, like, look, man, like, you know that we're always going to work together, but this is just something I got to do. It's my first album and what it's all about.
As a lyricist, like, is that part of it? Like, you know, I can hold the whole album on my own, you know?
I mean, yeah, I mean, like, here's the thing, like, people say like all types of crazy shit. There's people who think that I'm the wackest, have the wackest bars, and there's people, kids, that think I have the hardest bars in the game, you know what I'm saying? So it's more like I wanted to really just make songs and really not just make songs that would work for everyone, but make songs that are really about me and where I and what I'm about. And you know, it's like this whole like MC shit. Like, I pride myself on being able to rap. I pride myself on being able to spit and have a flow and really, like, master that craft. But at the end of the day, man, I'm a fucking musician, too. Like, I make music. I play instruments, and I've said that over and over again, and I do that shit, and I like to make songs. Like, I listen to more than just hip-hop, so, you know, whenever you do that, people are always like, oh, well, you can't even rap. And I'm like, yeah, dumbass, I wasn't trying to spit crazy bars on this song. I was like, but listen to this song. And it's kind of like, you know, I always wanna showcase that I have lyrical ability while being able to cross over, not into mainstream, that whack-ass word, but into just making music, and that will really, like, change the world. But yeah, but on this album, though, it's fucking, this is the hardest bars I've ever spit in my life, for real.
Are there any standout tracks you could tell us about other than the single, or a little glimpse of something?
I'm just gonna say that the tracks really, like, embody the album, you know, Blue Slide Park. It really, like, the track titles and everything are all things that are around, and they're just, like, things that everyone might not understand, but people where I come from will know exactly what it is, and you know, it's kind of about, less about putting a track title or making a song concept that's trying to relate to other people, and more just making it where I feel like me, regular, I can get along with a lot of people, so I can relate to a lot of people just being me, so there's no reason to change that up for the album, you know?